Dear students, welcome back to the video lectures of chapter 3. In the first lecture, we have gone through all the basics of chapter 3. I hope you have got the basics of chapter 3. And after the completion of the short note of method of least square and interpretation of regression coefficient B, we have to deal with students exercise 3.1. Now students, in exercise 3.1 we have all long sums, and students, due to limitation of space available, long sums we will skip at present. First let us take the basics of the chapter. We will do the short sums theories, and last we will come back to the long sums. So the next topic, so for the time being students, we are skipping 3.1 and starting the theories after 3.2. So please try to understand. Now the next theory students, it is of utility of study of regression. Many a times asked theory in board exam for 2 marks. And here there are 4 points students. If you remember the definition of regression, regression is a mathematical rule or a functional rule or a mathematical equation connecting independent variable x and dependent variable y. That was regression. Linear regression means it is also a mathematical equation or functional rule between independent variable x and dependent variable y, such that powers of x and y are 1. Now students, in the utility of regression, the first point, you know that with the help of regression we can determine a functional rule or a mathematical equation between independent variable x and y. So the first point, regression helps us to develop a mathematical equation between x and y. Now if you remember, on the very first day in the first lecture students, I told that regression formula or regression equation has 3 names: prediction formula, estimation formula and forecasting formula. So after developing the mathematical equation, you can say students, regression is used to estimate the values of independent variable y for a given value of independent variable x. So after developing the mathematical form, regression is used to estimate y, which is dependent variable, for a given value of x, which is independent variable. Then in the interpretation of regression coefficient, we studied that when x changes by 1 unit, y changes by b unit. Students, I am using the word change because when x increases by 1 unit and if b is positive, then y will increase by b units, and if x increases by 1 unit and b is negative, then y decreases by how many units? B units. So I have used the word change, either increase or decrease, based on the numerical sign of regression coefficient B. Last but not the least students, that this is a very important formula even to find the error of estimation or error of approximation by using the formula E is equal to Y minus Y cap. Based on regression line, we can find the error of estimation E, which is given by the formula Y minus Y cap. So students, very important theory, 4 points, utility in the study of regression or utility of study of regression. First point, regression is a functional rule, or with the help of regression we can develop a functional rule or mathematical equation between independent variable x and dependent variable y. After finding regression equation, we can estimate the value of y for a given value of x, y dependent, x independent. Based on regression, we can find the change in increase or decrease in y. If b is positive, then when x changes by 1 unit, y increases by b unit. And if b is negative, then when x increases by 1 unit, y decreases by b unit. And last but not the least, with the help of regression line, we can find the error in estimation e given by the formula yi minus yi cap. Now students, today I am going to summarize the basics of entire chapter. Students, today I am going to summarize the basics of entire chapter. In regression, in this chapter, actually students, what we have to do? Then the answer is written on the board. In this chapter, based on given data, we have to find the regression line of y on x. Remember, y is dependent and x is independent. In every question of 3.1, 3.2, 3.3 and henceforward on your students, you check, you are asked to find a regression line. So students, whenever you are asked to find a regression line in this chapter for any long sum, or students for any short sum, start with this step which I have written. The regression line of y on x is y cap is equal to a plus bx. Sorry students. Now the formulas to find b and a. Which formula we will use to find generally b? A has a common formula students, but I have written it first. Logic is that first we have to find b. The reason is b is required to find a. Now if you remember students, in correlation we had written criteria to use the formula. Same criteria are extended to find the formulas to decide the formula for regression coefficient b. So students, in the sums, how to find b and which formula to use to find b will be an important decision. So if you remember, in correlation, the first formula was used, students, when x bar and y bar were integers. Same in regression also, this first formula of b, which is sigma x minus x bar into y minus y bar upon sigma x minus x bar whole square, students, this formula is used only when x bar and y bar are integers. So mean are the decisive factors to decide the formula of b. Now in regression, remember one very important thumb rule, students, and that thumb rule is the content of formula written in denominators. Since this is a regression line of y on x, since this is a regression line of y on x, always x term will come in the denominator. I repeat, since this is a regression line of y on x, students, always x term will be there in the denominator. Now, second formula, when one of the means x bar and y bar are not integer or both are not integers. So in that case, our alternative formula to find r, same numerator is there, n sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y upon n sigma x square minus sigma x the whole square. The another important difference which you have to locate is there is no square root, students, in the denominator. So what are the basic distinctions between the formulas of correlation and regression? In correlation, we used to have two terms in the denominator. In regression, we will have always the term of x. And the second important distinction or difference, in correlation, we used to have square roots in the denominator. In regression students, we don't have square roots. Formula are used within the same conditions and criteria. So that I have written a second formula. I have not written that this is used when x bar and y bar are not integers, but students, you can easily understand. Now comes the most important one, shortcut method formula. In exam, most probably 99.99% we have to go by the shortcut method formula. The same formula we have already studied in correlation. Now the most important point of entire chapter. Keep your eyes and ears open while I am explaining this. Correlation coefficient R was independent of change of origin and scale. It means that we were writing like this, u is equal to x minus a upon cx and v is equal to y minus b upon cy. Means if I subtract or add and if I divide or multiply and then find new variables uv and I find correlation between uv, that was same as the correlation between x and y. So students, revise this, refer this in correlation. We had this basic axiomatic assumption and basic result that correlation coefficient R is independent of change of origin and scale. Whereas regression coefficient B, students, is only independent of change of origin but not scale. It means we are not authorized to divide or multiply in finding B for shortcut method formula. So this technically CX and CY are not feasible. So students, the basic difference between correlation coefficient R and regression coefficient B, once again I repeat, correlation coefficient R is independent of change of origin and scale, whereas regression coefficient B is only independent of change of origin but not scale. It means we cannot divide or multiply to find B in terms of UV method or shortcut method. But students, in mathematics and statistics, we find solution for every problem. Say suppose you take two common, or simply you multiply an equation by two, and if you want to nullify the effect, then we divide by two. Say I have an equation x minus 2. Now I want to divide by 2, then simultaneously I should multiply by 2. So instead of x minus 2, I can write 2x minus 4 upon 2. It is the same thing. So even though division is not possible in regression coefficient B and we want to divide, we finally balance that by multiplying. Finally students, we balance that by multiplying by cy upon cx. So what you people have to understand, technically B is not independent of change of scale, so we cannot divide. That is fair, but still I want to divide it. It is not allowed, but still I am dividing to scale down the numbers. So to nullify that, we have to multiply by cy upon cx. So division and multiplication balances. You divide by 2 and you multiply by 2. 2 by 2 is 1. Your answer will remain same. So in the shortcut method formula to find B, we simply replace x by u and y by v in the alternative formula. So the formula will be n sigma uv minus sigma u into sigma v upon n sigma u square minus sigma u the whole square. Why I am multiplying by cy by cx? The reason is division technically, conceptually not possible, but still I am dividing. To balance that, we have to multiply by cy upon cx. So in the shortcut method formula to find regression coefficient b, always with the formula we will multiply by cy upon cx. Suppose we haven't divided, then this value cx and cy will be considered 1. So 1 upon 1 is still 1. So we are multiplying by 1, the answer will not change. So students, here I have explained you a very important concept of regression coefficient b. Regression coefficient b is only independent of change of origin but not scale. So division not possible, but in mathematics to scale down the number still we divide. To balance that we have to multiply by cy upon cx. So now students, one or two MCQs or VSQs based on this concept, let us take. Now students, pay attention. MCQ 6th I think we took. Now I am taking MCQ 7, just pay attention. Which regression line is used if sale of a commodity depends on its advertisement cost? You know, the more you advertise in this modern days, correspondingly your sales is more. So sale is dependent on advertisement cost. So advertisement cost is independent and sale is dependent. So the answer is, regression line of sales on advertisement cost. Always I told you, regression line of y on x means y is dependent variable which we have to write first, after that on, and after on we have to write independent variable. So as per the MCQ 7, which regression line is used if sale of a commodity depends on its advertisement cost? The answer is regression line of sales on advertisement cost. Then which of the following is a regression line of y on x? 8th MCQ students, which of the following is a regression line of y on x? The answer is y cap is equal to a plus bx. So as per the correct option, the answer is C. As per the correct option students, the answer is C. So one has to be very cautious in understanding the theories students, and this is very simple once you understand. Now I am taking MCQ 11. If the regression line of y on x is y cap is equal to 10 plus 3x, what is the estimate of y for x is equal to 20? MCQ 11. In the line 10 plus 3x, y cap is equal to 10 plus 3x, take x is equal to 20. 20 into 3, 60. 60 plus 10, the answer of y is 70. So very easily, our utility of regression is justified, that based on regression line, we can estimate the value of dependent variable y for a given value of independent variable x. So students, we have done MCQ 7, we have done MCQ 8, and we have done MCQ 11. Now if I come back to section B, I think first 5 questions we have already done. Now let us do VSQ question 6, question 7 and question 8. Now here students, pay maximum attention. Question 6, the regression coefficient is independent of which transformation? Just now I told, regression coefficient B is independent of change of origin. Means we can either subtract A and B from X and Y, or even we can add A and B to X and Y. Students, change of origin does not mean always subtraction, it also means addition. So VSQ 6, the regression coefficient is independent of which transformation? Students, the answer to this is, the regression coefficient is independent of change of origin. Seventh, the regression coefficient is not independent of which transformation? The answer to the seventh question, the regression coefficient is not independent of which transformation? I say change of scale. We are not authorized to divide by Cx and Cy while we are finding regression coefficient B. So regression coefficient B is not independent of which transformation, students? The answer is it is not independent of change of scale. Means we can neither divide nor we can multiply. 7th VSQ asked in March 2020 examination 8, what is the value of error if a sample point is on the fitted line? Now for this, students, I advise you to refer the scatter diagram which is given on page 119. If you carefully observe the points, check for x1 y1 and x1 y1 cap, if the estimated point x1 y1 cap is below the regression line, the value, check here students, pay attention, on page 119, the error will be positive for points above the line and the error will be negative for points below the line. For points below the estimated regression line, the error will be negative, and for points above the regression line, the error term will be always positive, and of course for points exactly on the regression line, the error value will be zero. A very important VSQ. Error of estimation is E is equal to yi minus yi cap. If the point is above the regression line, error will have a positive value. If the point is below the regression line, error term E will have a negative value. And if the point is on the regression line, the error will have zero value. This VSQ was asked, students, in March 2020 board examination, one of the most important VSQ. So students, try to understand this. It is actually very, very easy. So this is what I wanted to summarize, students. So in this chapter, for the time being, we will be going for short sums and all basic formulas. I suggest, I advise you to write these formulas 5 times and memorize. And in the next lecture, we will be going with more concepts and sums, especially the short sums. I told you, for the time being, we will avoid long sums. Write formulas, memorize it, very simple. Try to observe the difference. Okay, students, so with this, we conclude the lecture. A new lecture will upload on Monday. So we will upload our lectures regularly on Monday, Wednesday and Friday. Thank you, students.